DCT units or dual clutch transmissions or automatic transmissions that are based on manual gearbox engineering. Basically, this is a manual gearbox with a very tricky clutch system that combines two clutches and two shafts that separately control certain sets of gears. The clutches are controlled by the TCU, which is also very tricky and complicated, and combines an electronic control unit and the mechanical hydraulic part that basically tells the clutches to shift gears. Although the DCT design is largely seen as not really reliable, the initial engineering is pretty simple. While dry clutch transmissions keep failing early and require a lot of money on clutch pack replacement, wet clutch models do pretty well and may last as long as conventional automatic transmissions on average. But DCTs are much more heavily engineered and they require certain conditions to last a long time. I want to tell you about several unobvious reasons that very often lead to DCT problems. First of all, it's the condition of your battery and alternator. The dual clutch transmission includes a very fragile electronic control unit that requires a proper voltage supply. Any voltage drop can easily fry this module, so it's important to pay attention to the condition of your battery. The most common scenario is when the 6 or 7 year old battery drops voltage when you crank the engine, the TCU may be damaged and it will start glitching, throwing various codes and refusing to work completely. The TCU is usually packed in one module with the hydraulic control system, and the module is often referred to as mechatronic. So the only way to fix your transmission after this happens is to replace the mechatronic. The average cost of the part is 1,500 euros if bought new from the dealership, but it depends on the manufacturer, of course. So it makes sense to check your battery, especially prior to the winter season when it's most likely to fail. And it's obviously cheaper to replace the battery even prior to its actual problems than to replace the TCU in your dual clutch transmission. But let's develop this voltage-related topic a little more. I personally know about several cases when DCT transmissions failed due to bad ground connections on the car body. When the ground is not perfect, the voltage may go up and down, and this affects modern cars very badly. So regular inspection of ground connections is quite a good idea. You may locate those grounds by tracking down the cables from the negative terminal of the main battery. And one more thing, I wouldn't recommend jump starting your car with the DCT using jumper cables, as well as jump starting any other car using your vehicle's battery as the donor battery. This creates voltage spikes and drops in the system and may eventually affect the fragile TCU. And then there is the second major problem that people don't tend to think about. If you have a wet clutch DCT like Volkswagen 6-speed DSG, for example, it means that a clutch pack is submerged in fluid and there is much more fluid in the transmission than in a dry clutch DCT. These cars need fluid cooling equipment since the fluid is used as a cooler for the clutch pack and it's heated up quite heavily. So these transmissions use a heat exchanger where your coolant lowers the temperature of the fluid. If the coolant level drops, this heat exchanger loses its efficiency and the transmission gets overheated. There are usually no temperature sensors, so you will not know about this. It makes sense to keep the coolant closer to the maximum mark on the coolant tank in this case. Also, very often these DCT heat exchangers may fail because of the glycol-rich coolant used in the system. Glycol causes corrosion in the system and the DCT heat exchanger is often the first part that fails and starts leaking coolant into the transmission fluid. You will not notice this since the leak is completely internal and the only sign of it is the slight coolant level drop. But what happens inside your transmission is that the glycol-rich coolant starts affecting the clutch friction plates. It means that just after several days, your clutch system will require replacement. If you keep driving with coolant in the DCT fluid, you will completely destroy the transmission due to the changed fluid viscosity and hydraulic problems. Of course, there are more common sense reasons for failure, like not changing fluid in the wet clutch transmission, or towing more than the manufacturer commands, or abusing the car that's not made for an active driving style, or keeping the car in place on the hill by slightly pressing the gas pedal etc. But I hope you learned something new about DCT transmissions that seem to be flooding the market now and becoming one of the most obvious alternatives to conventional automatic transmissions.